Hello students, I look at the question. Set builder form of a set of points x comma y given. That means area. The set of points belongs to the common region or feasible region between these two plane. And 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to x square plus 1. Because of the inequality, this quadratic inequality represents a plane, and 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to x plus 1, this also plane. So this can be either lower or upper half plane. The first one is parabolic plane, exterior or interior. Parabolic plane, either interior or exterior. Exterior to the parabola. So how to decide the plane represent interior or exterior? This is parabola, yes, y equal to x square plus 1 parabola, yes, of x square, open upper direction, yes, if we change x by minus x, there won't be any change in the function, so this is symmetric about x equal to 0, symmetric about x equal to 0, that is y axis, so symmetric about y axis, and the coefficient of y positive in open upward direction. This is a straight line, and we have to decide the plane without inequality. Y equal to x plus 1 is a straight line, and 0 less than or equal to y less than or equal to x plus 1 represent plane. A plane of infinity is divided by a straight line. The plane above the line is upper half plane, or below the line a lower half plane. So it can be decided with the help of the origin. If we take 0 comma 0 is a testing point, just take x comma x equal to 0, y equal to 0, then this inequality 0 is less than 1, correct? So 0 comma 0 satisfies. That means 0 comma 0 is part of the plane. If 0 comma 0 below the line means the plane is lower half plane. The 0 comma 0 above the line means the plane can be upper half plane. So we can decide with the help of the testing point 0 comma 0. But here, and y equal to x square plus 1. When x equal to 0, y equal to 1. So this is parabola open upper direction with the vertex and 0 comma 1. When x equal to 0, y equal to 1. 0 comma 1 is the vertex mean. We can take 0 comma 2 is the interior point of the parabola. And 0 comma 0 exterior to the parabola. So we take 0 comma 0 here exterior to the parabola. X equal to 0, y equal to 0. So 0 less than 1, correct? So 0 comma 0 satisfy this inequality mean. So what is this? The parabola, parabolic plane. What kind of parabolic plane? Exterior to the parabola is not interior to the parabola, because with respect to the parabola, y equal to x square plus 1, 0 comma 0, exterior point lies outside of the parabola, y equal to x square plus 1. So being the exterior point 0 comma 0 satisfy this inequality, this is nothing but a plane which is exterior to the parabola y equal to x square plus 1, and this is a plane and 0 comma 0 satisfy. So we have decide the 0 comma 0 is under or above, then we can decide. Then we have to find the area between the range lower limit 0, upper limit 2. Now let us start to discuss a rough sketch of the given question. Okay, 0, 0. When x equal to 0, y equal to 1. So this is the vertex of the parabola, 0, 1. And if yes, have x square and y coefficient of y is positive, it's open upper direction. It's going like this. It's going like this. Okay. Now, this is the point origin, 0, 0. If we substitute x equal to 0, y equal to 0 in the inequality, the quadratic inequality, and the quadratic inequality is satisfied by the origin, x equal to 0, y equal to 0, that means the plane, this plane contains 0, 0, or 0, 0 is one of the points in the plane, and y less than or equal to x square plus 1 means this is exterior to the parabola. The exterior to the parabola. The exterior to the parabola is represented by y is less than or equal to x square plus 1, but inside y is greater than or equal to x square plus 1. Y greater than x square plus 1, interior parabola. Y is less than x square plus 1, exterior, and because of equal to mean right from the curve, parabolic curve. So we have to take this, and we should not consider this because y is less than or equal to x square plus 1, satisfied by 0, 0. Okay, then we have to decide whether the parabola and the y equal to x plus 1 intersect or not. To decide y equal to x plus 1 and y equal to x square plus 1. If you compare these two with the help of y, x plus 1 will be equal to x square plus 1 and x equal to x square, and this implies x into x minus 1 equal to 0. This implies x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. So the parabola and straight line meet at two points, x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. X equal to 0, somewhere we can take x equal to 1. The equation ordinate x equal to 1. This is the point of intersection of the parabola y equal to x square plus 1 and the straight line y equal to x plus 1. So we can connect this chord and x time. Okay, with respect to the line 0, 0, below the line 0, 0 satisfy me. So this is lower half plane, lower. Lower half plane only. Okay, and x value between 0 and 2, x equal to 0 and x equal to somewhere, the parabola is going like this. Both the side we have to extend like this. So 1, 2, this x equal to 2, and remember, look at the first inequality, the y value in both the case, y value greater than or equal to 0, y value greater than or equal to 0, so y coordinate should be greater than or equal to 0, so we can conclude x greater than or equal to 0, y greater than or equal to 0 mean, what is the indication? We have to get the area only in the first quadrant. In the first quadrant, x greater than or equal to 0 and y also greater than or equal to 0. So according to the intersection, this is the required area. Below the line, this area and the another area. So we can separate into two areas, A1 and A2. Look at the area A1. A1 is the area bounded by the parabola, segment of the parabola, and two ordinate x equal to 0 and x equal to 1, and y equal to 0, that is x axis, first area. The second area bounded by two ordinate x equal to 1 and x equal to 2, and the part of the line y equal to x plus 1, and the line y equal to 0, that is x axis. So the bounded area A for the first area let us have one small rectangular strip. What is the variable height? This, the upper portion touches parabola, so yp dx. Here another rectangular strip. What is the variable height? And y of the line, yl dx. And dx width there also. So the area yp dx, integral of yp dx between x equal to 0 and x equal to 1, we can get the first area. Integral of yl dx and between x equal to 1 and x equal to 2, we can get the second area a2. The first area a1, integral of yp dx and x equal to 0 to 1. Then second area yl dx and from x equal to 1 to 2. Okay, and go through it. And yp is nothing but the y value is taken from parabola. This we can replace yp equal to x square plus 1 and yl equal to x plus 1. So 0 to 1, yp is x square plus 1 dx, and 1 to 2, yl is x plus 1 dx. Yes, we are going to integrate. After applying upper limit and lower limit, we can estimate what is the area according to the question. Just go through it, we continue. Let us continue now. The integral of x square plus 1, x cube by 3 plus x, lower limit 0, upper limit 1. But second, integral of x plus 1, x square by 2 and plus x with the lower limit and upper limit. Then area, bounded area, taking 1 by 3 outside, or straight away lower limit 0 means is 1 cube by 3, 1 by 3 plus 1. Then taking 1 by 2 outside, x square, 2 square minus 1, 4 minus 1, 3 plus 2 minus 1, 1. So 1 by 3 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4 by 3 plus 3 by 2 plus 1, taking 3 into 2, 6 LCM, and 2 into 4, 8, 3 into 3, 9 plus 6, so 9, 15, 23 by 6. Okay, once again, x cube by this integral of x square, x cube by 3 and x, so 1 by 3 and plus 1. Then 1 by 2 outside, because the x square, 2 square minus 1 square, 4 minus 1, 3 and 2 minus 1. So 3 by 2 and 1 by 3 plus 1, 4 by 3 and 1, 6, least common multiple of the 3 fraction. So 2 into 3 is 8. And 3, 9 and 6, so 9 plus 6, 15, 23 by 6 square units. Just go through it.